Today's number is 82,000, which is a weird number to kind of arbitrary sounding number to talk about, because this is what I want to do. Imagine this sequence. I'm going to start this sequence with a 2, a 3, 4, the next number, 82,000. What's the next number? I'm not going to torture you with this one. I'm not going to make you do the riddle for this one because we don't know what the next number is. So this sequence is about using different bases. Normally, we use base 10. Base 10 means, well, if I took a number like 231, then what that means is we are doing two lots of 100, which is actually 10 squared. We then add on three lots of 10 itself, and then we add on one lot, in that case, of 10 to the 0. So one lot of 1, 10 to the 0 is 1. And so that's how regular numbers work. It's powers of 10 that we're adding together. But there's nothing special about the number 10, so we can do this with any number. We can choose any base, and in general, if we had a base, let's call it base B, what that means is we're using the digits 0, 1, 2, 3, up to B minus 1, and then we are looking at powers of B. So that would start with B to the 0, which is 1, and then it'd be B itself, then it's B squared and B cubed and B to the 4. Shall we have a little bit of practice? Shall we do that in a different base?
Yeah.
Let's do it in base 5. It's 231 in base 5. It's written as 1411. It's still the same number. It's still 231. It still has the same size. Shall I do base 6? Does it really make that point? Have a look. So in base 6, it's written as 1023. So we can write numbers in different bases. All right, let's do this for 82,000. Let's see what we get in different bases. Let's start by doing it in base 2. Right, that's the most simple one you can do, all right. In base 2, it is, and I have to look this up, 101000, 0000, 010, 100, and a couple more zeros on the end of that. What does this mean? This means it's 2 to the 16 plus 2 to the 14 plus 2 to the 6. Plus 2 to the 4. So that's what it looks like in base 2. In base 3, it looks like this. 110, 111, 110, 01. Right, let's try it in base 4. It looks like this. 110, 001, 100. And I'm gonna do one more, base 5. Let's look at that. What are you expecting to happen? Now, 101, 110, 00. What's happened is in 82,000, in every base, well, base 2, base 3, base 4, base 5, it's written as ones and zeros. It's always ones and zeros. So a number doesn't have to be written as ones and zeros. In base 2, numbers are always written in ones and zeros. But in base 3, we have no digit 2s here. In base 4, we have no digit 3s here. For 82,000, it's always written in ones and zeros. And it does appear to be the only number that has this property that can be written in ones and zeros in base 2, base 3, base 4, and base 5 as well. Let's take a look at this sequence. Why is this a sequence then? Because if we were only talking about base 2, then the smallest number you could write using ones and zeros without being 1 itself, which is too easy, is the number 2. In base 2, it's 10. And that's the number 2. The smallest number you can write using base 2 and base 3 in ones and zeros only is the number 3. If I'm allowed to use base 2, base 3 and base 4 using ones and zeros only, the smallest number I can do that is the number 4. If I'm allowed to do it in base 2, base 3, base 4 and base 5, the smallest number that you can do that with ones and zeros only is 82,000. So it's pottering along nicely and then suddenly, boom, 82,000. And this might be the only number that you can write. So what's the next number? The next number is a number, or the smallest number, that we could write using base 2, 3, 4, 5, and base 6. Now, unfortunately, 82,000 fails to to do that on base 6. Let's look at that. In base 6, 82,000 is written as this. 1, 4, 3. Oh, already I'm disappointed. 1, 3, 4, 4. So, oh, it's already failing there. Now, if there is a next number there, it would have to be written in ones and zeros in base 6, but it has to be written in ones and zeros in base 5 and 4 and 3 and 2. We think 82,000 is the only number that can be written like this up to base 5. So there can't be one that satisfies this for base 6 as well, because it has to satisfy all the others. It's an open problem. It's still an open problem. And we have checked numbers up to 2,000 digits long. So we have looked for this. Is it the only number? And then if there is another number, is that number a candidate for the next number in this sequence? Because I take that a step further and look at base 6 then.
Today's episode of Number File has been brought to you by a book. Not just any book, it's this one. How Not to Be Wrong by Jordan Ellenberg. This is a bestseller. It's really popular. Lots of people I speak to have been talking about it. In fact, the quote here on the front says, "A delight full of simple yet deep insights about many areas of modern life." And that quote is from Alex Belos, who is in loads of Number File videos. So what more recommendation do you want? Jordan may be known to a lot of you through a column he writes for Slate, which is very good. And the book is like that, but even better. I mean, obviously it's very clever mathematically, but also really funny and witty. He's a really smart guy and makes you laugh while you're reading it, which I really like. He's also a genius at chapter names. Check out some of these. These are chapters in the book. Less Like Sweden, Everyone is Obese. How Much Is That in Dead Americans? The Baltimore Stockbroker and the Bible Code. Dead Fish Don't Read Minds. I could have told you that. What to Expect When You're Expecting to Win the Lottery. Miss More Planes. There Is No Such Thing as Public Opinion. I love the titles he uses. I think I should employ him to write the titles for Number File videos. If you like books about mathematics, you'll love this. And if you don't read books about mathematics, this is a good place to start. This is one of the best ones out there. How Not to Be Wrong: The Hidden Maths of Everyday Life is the subtitle, although I have seen it with other subtitles elsewhere. You'll find it everywhere you normally get books from, and I'll put a link in the video description if you want to go straight to it and add it to your collection. I'm reading it at the moment, and when I finish, it will be going on a little shelf I have over there full of all my favourite math books. And thank you to a book, and what an appropriate book, for supporting Number File.